Okay, today we're going to be continuing looking at the Nichi Sonji Reddit to see on our more posts and memes and stuff. I mean, it's still not dying down, okay? There's still more, I guess, fun to be had. I don't know how to describe it, but you keep giving off these kinds of vibe satire, by the way. So it's a meme, so they're fake. Friendly reminder that white people don't get to celebrate Lunar New Year's unless they're literally invited by someone who is from a country that does. Friendly reminder, I hereby formally invite everyone to celebrate Lunar New Year. Bruh. Okay, God, okay, bruh. It's a meme. I mean, essentially, as a Chinese person, like, Lunar New Year is sort of like, anybody can celebrate it, right? I mean, you have like, Chinatowns, you know, in Western countries, like in Australia there is one, and yeah, people like celebrate Chinese New Year. It's really like, it's very much like meant to be, it's like family, it's just like getting together, like anybody can get together and can celebrate it, can respect the culture. Nichi Sonji stands converting to racism to defend their Oshi needs to be studied? Converting to racism? I refuse to believe Nichi Sonji fans have always been racist, and all of a sudden their brain tint racism are just coming out of the woodworks. I feel like I need to see like proof of that. I can't just say like, oh, the fan, like there's like fans of like in a general sense, fans are just blatantly racist. I don't know. I mean, I guess I'm just saying like what some of the people that are defending, some of the fans who are defending Yuki, I guess that's what they're saying. Is this just a result of the general fan base being on the younger side? What? Are they saying that they think the general fan base is like being like blatantly racist? I don't really understand, and thus being more impressionable and emotionally exploitable. I really want to know what's happening here. I feel like it's unfair. Like, I feel like in all of these cases, right? Like, you can say this, right? But I don't think making a generalization is fair, and being like, oh, why are all Nichi Sonji fans blatant racism, like blatant racists, like being like Nichi Sonji fans have always been racist, you know, or like saying like blatant racism. I don't agree with that. I don't like making like a generalized statement of being like, because this is really like, it feels like they're making like a general statement saying like, oh yeah, Nichi fans in general are racist, which is just like, no, I don't think that's true at all. Like, I don't think you're making a general statement or like a broad like generalization, right? I literally encountered someone who said they'd rather be a white savior, aka from a racist. What is a white savior? I don't. Than a white bootlicker. They're very far gone at this point. There, unironically, is a very dangerous and racist mindset, both individually and systematically. Not true. Scottman fallacy. Most of them are against racism, but they're pro-Uki, so they compensate by saying it's not real racism, just like Vox implied that what happened to Selene wasn't real bullying. It's a very common logical fallacy and no one is immune. T-I-L, that's actually pretty interesting, and Nichi's whole PR stunt could probably be used as a case study slash real life example that effect. Like, I don't know, I just feel like, like making like a generalized statement, be like, oh, why are like all Nichi fans quote unquote racist? Like, I always like hate that, because it's like, that's not like the, this is not like the generalized like all the fan base. Like, this is probably like more of a just like, you know, the Uki, like, I don't know, just Uki fans, or it's not all the fans. I just don't like people who make like generalizations. I mean, like, an entire group is like this. Like, saying like an entire fan base is racist is like a big sort of thing to say, right? Daily reminded that Nichi Ien's gross mismanagement produced an unsafe work environment that almost cost on their life. 100% true. Average Nichi Sanji defender argument. Doki is lying. Doki was the real bully. Racism. Are they saying that like there's people being racist? Wait, what do they mean by that? Or like, are they saying like? I don't know what the racism they're saying by the racism. Like, are they saying like, I don't know what they mean by that, like by the like racism thing, but hashtag. Love for Uki's trying on X by Uki fans showing their support despite everything happened. I mean, honestly, about like these tags, so I just feel like just leave it to me. I was like, if Uki fans want to show their support for Uki, like go ahead. It's kind of how I sort of feel on these things. Like, I'm not gonna go out of my way to like engage or like, you know, post like memes and shit in that hashtag. It's like, because honestly, I don't really care, right? I just don't care. It's more like, you know, if you're a fan of Uki, if you want to show him support, go ahead. It's more of like, I'm not really somebody who wants to like try and like sway people's opinions. It's like, you can come to your own conclusions. If you want to support, if you want to defend him, go ahead and defend him. If you want to continue supporting him, you can support him. I'm just gonna like leave it be, kind of. That's how I sort of feel on like the whole like hashtag thing. It's like, I don't know, just let it be. Interesting tweets from an old friend. Long somewhat positive rant about spending time with friends and making new ones. I felt insanely blessed. They are, and this is Mika. She left, so I think it's fine to say that. Insanely blessed. They are so creative, kind, and ambitious, and for the first time in a while, I feel inspired to do something out of love and passion instead of fear and hurt. Fear and hurt? I'm so used to people treating me like I'm less than slash as a stepping stone to meet someone more popular and then ghosting me afterwards. What the fuck? I have times where people tell me how nice someone is, but from my experience, they're quite condescending, so I would only apply with oh. I chalked it up to it's just business slash it is what it is, and I was okay with that. But over time, I subconsciously trend to tend to put myself last on everyone's priority list, even on my own. I never knew how much that affected my mental health and confidence till recently. This trip, my friends were there for me. They aren't shy to admit they're my friends and always checked up on how I'm doing. They went above and beyond to take care of me when I'm sick, house me, feed me, meet me, even if I'm a nobody. They made me feel like I mattered. I feel amazing, like you realize I'm not a burden. I have people and friends that genuinely just love me for me. I'm so inspired and thankful and happy right now. I want to do things to make people around me proud and make my friends proud. This will be a great year. Oh, that's really sweet. I don't know if some of the things that she's saying is like talking about like her past and the company and saying like maybe it's in the context of like people use her as a stepping stone to, I don't know, to like maybe get into that clique or get into like collabs like Nichi Ien members. I don't exactly know. I'm not going to like go too into like detail like speculation, but thought I would post one of 4chan's rare coherent non-schizo moments. What is this? Can I read this? Oh, okay. People like this really need a reality. What is they? Are they responding to something, or people like this really need a reality check? A very big, long overdue reality check, seeing a small handful of young, impressionable people defending Uki's behavior like this makes me want to sit them in a fucking corner. I'm making this tweet, I'm not making this post to attack Uki, I'm making it to express my extreme disappointment anonymously. My hope is that even if this is mocked by other Aeron, I don't know how to pronounce that name, there's a chance an unrelated live that can read it and maybe, okay, Okay, let's just say this. Livers should not go on 4chan. This is like in a general sense. Livers should not go and look at 4chan. Like, don't look at 4chan. Livers should not be going on 4chan. Like, just in a general sense. Like, if you're a creator and people are talking about you on 4chan, don't fucking look at 4chan. Like, just don't go on 4chan. Reality speaking, like, Nietzsche Ian Livers should not be looking at 4chan. Like, don't look at 4chan. Like, don't go on 4chan. Like, just don't. An unrelated liver can read it and maybe learn a little lesson. It blows my mind knowing despite the stress and turmoil that's going on inside the Niji Ian sphere right now, his ashamed bitterness and hatred of white people was stronger than the worsening reputation of his company and the mental well-being of his friends and colleagues. Jokes have punchlines, while some of his other comments could have been fairly low-bro jokes about a person's race, he wasn't responding to that tweet as a joke. He was responding out of anger. Honestly, I kind of agree. Like, I don't think that his response was, like, a joke. Like, it seemed like that this person was responding, like, this person, like, tweeted to Yuki's, like, art tweet, just like to troll and get a reaction out of him, and it seemed like sort of like an emotional or even sort of like an emotional or like triggered response. Like, it did not seem like it was joking. It's not like it's not like Vivi. You know, Vivi's response was more like sort of more like joking and more like seemed more like lighthearted in that sense. But Yuki did seem like he basically like fell into like getting a bit triggered by this person. I mean, and reacted a bit emotionally, and like, there's no like real way I can like excuse that, because definitely the response was not right, and he should have handled that a lot better, or at the very least, if he was going to respond, he should respond in a much better way. He responded in a terrible way. He was responding out of anger. Can you imagine for a second that your company is under one of the worst PR disasters in recent VTuber history, and you still take the time to respond to the worst bait imaginable? Yeah, like literally, yeah, that's really true. It's bait. And this person literally, yeah, said it's bait. Like, this whole like thing wouldn't have happened if Yuki just never would have responded. If he never would have responded to that tweet, none of this would have happened. So inherently, it is his own fault, inevitably, and he does deserve criticism for that response. Imaginable, with a tweet that only serves as throwing gasoline onto an already raging fire. 100%. Would you do it? Would you want your name here, Slacism, to be one of the first Google searched results when people search for you? Is that, I don't think that's true, but I mean, I guess it could, like, in a hypothetical sense of speaking. Or when your future employers Google your past work to see if you're fit for the role? It doesn't matter if 5,000 or even 10,000 people on Twitter agree with you. When you realize that Twitter isn't real and you see your takes from the eyes of some regular schmuck on the street, it doesn't look good no matter which way you try to swing it. I hope he reflects on this fact, as it is pretty embarrassing thing to be the poster boy for outside of the very small hug box that is his fan base and even the VTuber community. This news will follow him through his indie career. I don't know if it's maybe, I don't know. I feel like over time this may, like, I don't think it's such a massive thing that like in like a year this is going to still like hang over him. Possibly, but I don't think like this discourse is gonna be as massive. Like I don't think that, but I don't know, we will see. I don't know. To a certain extent, I think it will hang over him, but I don't know if it's going to be like, indicative of actually like, hurting his career in any way. Let's see, his indie career, especially how now big name YouTubers are starting to pay attention and what it may affect a certain crowd to his content. I mean, it might affect him, I don't know, we'll see, you know, in that sense. And he might undoubtedly thrive with this community. He will not be able to shake this bad look unless he accepts he fucked up and admits that he's at least able to recognize why making those comments can be considered as wrong. The way he referred to that old couple was borderline psychotic. The fact his brain immediately labeled a warm greeting from an elderly couple as non-furious double motive is extremely revealing that to his bait against white folk. I don't really know if it's the fact that they're white like, I don't really, like, okay, the whole, like, thing about, like, seeing the thing of the white couple, I don't know specifically if it's the fact of just white people walking up to him, and it's specifically the reason reacted like that was because they're white. Like, I feel like, from what he said after that, he was talking about, like, how, like, from his experiences, it sounds like it's, like, some trauma from, like, past experiences. So, to me, it kind of just seemed like, obviously, I can, like, my interpretation, it sort of just kind of felt like he was just uncomfortable with people coming up to him and saying hi to him, and it, like, maybe it spooked him a little bit, I don't know, but still, it's kind of, like, reacting that way, or even, like, after the fact that it happened, to, like, comment on it and talk about it and, like, have it in your head still seems a bit, like, odd to me, because in the context of, like, well, if it's just, like, a random, like, older couple, like, saying hi to you, and it's, like, you know, I'm an introvert, sometimes I don't want, like, people talking to me, I'm, like, you know, I'm sort of, it's, like, a little bit awkward, but I'm not gonna, like, that interaction is not gonna, like, be in my head, right? It's not gonna be, like, a continuing thing that sticks with me, so that's sort of, like, a thing that I can understand in that context or that sense, like, why. I mean, obviously, people interpret things differently. Maybe I need to rewatch the clip and things like that, and I don't know if it's, like, I don't know if he was, like, saying white couple was, like, a describing word, or he was actually, like, you know, the fact that they were white had something to do with it. I don't really know, but, you know, you can let me know in the comments. I probably need to rewatch that clip or something again, but I don't know. I just don't really know. Was it malicious? Was it maliciously because they were white? Is sort of like my, I don't know, my thing. It's like, if it was somebody else, would he have reacted differently? If it was like a different race elderly couple, would he like greet them, be nice to them? But it's like, oh my God, they're white. So he's like petty or mean against him. I don't know. I don't know if it's his racism. Like, is he actually racist to that extent? I don't know. I don't really know. Because that seems like having like actual, like, that seems like actual like prejudice. If he is like actually like offended or like taken back or like, you know, upset that like white people came and said hello to him. That is fucking racism, you know? So that is like pure like discrimination. So I don't know. Double motive extreme revealing to his bias against white folk. Was this gleaned from personal experiences, or is it TikTok brain rot? I don't know if it's TikTok brain rot. I don't know. Is it TikToks like say stuff like that? I don't know. But would it be nice to see him act his age and grow from these experiences? Because right now, all I see is an immature kid who needs to get off the internet for a few days and learn some common sense. Okay. I mean, yeah, it was pretty, I would say it was a pretty, like, at the end of the day, it was like, regardless of, like, I'm still, like, indifferent about, like, I'm just unsure about the white couple thing, but, no, in how this was, like, a pretty well-worded, like, criticism of Uki. Like, it was pretty well said. Like, it's, like, this is not, like, people might say, oh, this is hate. This is not hate, this is a criticism. Like, this is a well-worded criticism of his behavior. And basically, yeah, basically, so, like, just grow as a person and change. Like, pretty reasonable. Like, yeah, it's, like, legitimately, like, not, like, a pretty, like, reasonable post. Have a nice break with what? You peel? I don't know. Oh my God, and they're posting fucking white people is crazy. Like white elderly couples, that's kind of funny to be fair, but no. Niji Sunji criticism is now 4chan. You can't offer any criticism to some people in one particular, like the ableist fan keeps promoting that everything here became 4chan, so many are annoying legitimate criticism and even refusing to take accountability for their actions and the damage done after the fact. Why are some fans refusing to hold the company accountable? Yeah, that's crazy. You the company deserves to be held accountable. The company doesn't care for their Oshis, that much is clear. I wouldn't even give these fans the time of day. I'll just find what they are saying via Twitter. find what they are saying via Twitter and hit the report button. They aren't fans, and especially the ones who allowed ableism to run free. I haven't heard of ableism, I don't know. Run free with information that came from a doxing website. Fans were happy to cite as a source. Yeah, that's gross. Mind you, I don't mind every fan. There are fans who are just pretty chill, who love their oceans. Yeah, like, okay, the thing is, I don't like it when people always make a generalization. Like, you shouldn't make a generalization, but like, all fans are bad. Like, look at this. All the Niji fans are racist. Like, no, like, obviously that's not true. Like, obviously there are some fans who are chill and fine. It's just like, the vocal Twitter fans can be a bit crazy. And it's always like, it's like the vocal minority. Most fans and most of the audience actually just don't say anything. Are just people who are just watching streams and aren't on Twitter, like, saying things, right? It is like, it's the vocal minority, and always the vocal minority gets, people look at the vocal minority and then use that to, like, think of, and then it's sort of like, they're the loudest, so it's representative of the community as a whole, right? Because they're the vocal minority, they're the ones that they're the loudest, the ones that people see the most. I just don't like generalizing, right? I just don't like making generalizations and being like, oh, there's some bad apples in this community, so the entire community's bad. I hate that. I hate that, like, generalization when people do that. I don't like it. Mind you, I don't mind every fan. Fans who are just pretty chill, love their lives, but also demand better from the company. I know this isn't everyone. That's basically how I would say. That's like me inherently. Do my point is to report the fans. Don't block, just smash that report button. They clearly believe that if you block them, they win. They stupid mentally, so just report instead. Yeah, like replying and engaging with people is like just, it's just a waste of your time inherently. Niji Sunjis, I've never heard of that terminology. When someone criticizes their Oshi, shouldn't harass anyone because you harass said person. I mean, obviously not everybody, but there are people who do that, yeah, sadly. I mean, it's the same thing on like both sides, right? There's gonna be like those people on both sides at the end. Like, there are people that harass Niji Sunjis for still, like, being fans of Niji Sunji, and then there are these Niji Sunjis who will, harass somebody for criticizing their Oshi also. It's sort of like, there's these people on both ends. Like, always when there's, like, a drama, or there's an internet conflict or whatever, like, there's always bad apples on every side, and we should not, like, forget about that. Like, you know, this person, like, says that, like, Niji Sunji is, you shouldn't harass anyone, proceed to harass said person. It's the same thing as, like, the other side as well. Like, there are some bad apples to do that at the same time also, right? Apparently these people don't realize that by making more of a stink, people are going to judge the company even more. I don't know. So when will be Kojima of VTubing thrown out by company, communities follow it, making great content, making more sponsored, getting more sponsored off thrown out. Oh my god, this is kind of funny. Become the thing you always hated. Go white boy, go. Okay, this is kind of funny. Okay, I like this one. I actually like this one. That's kind of funny, actually. I like that one. I kind of find that one funny. I don't understand this one. Okay, I think that's basically, everything. Yeah, so let me know down in the comments what you guys think. I don't want to have like a whole like debacle or conversation like, oh my god, like, is Uki racist, whatever. Like, we kind of had that conversation before, yeah, so thank you guys for, if you want to, you can talk about that. I'm not gonna engage with that. Like, I don't know, I'm just sort of conflict on that, but I think definitely it is something to note. Like, yeah, his response didn't really, it wasn't a joke. Like, it didn't really seem like a joke, and I think that is an important thing to talk about, to say. It's like, yeah, that was not, like, it was that, like, sort of, like, but malicious? I mean, kinda, yeah. I mean, I don't know, it was sort of like a triggered sort of response. But, yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys did energize for your day on the J-Sphere. Please consider liking, subscribing, and watching me on my channel. Subscribing just helped me to continue to make more videos. And we're getting close to 20,000 subscribers. Again, please help me in reaching 20,000 subscribers. Please do consider hitting the subscribe button. Just helped me out a lot. And, yeah, let me know in the comments what you guys think. I guess if you want to talk about it, if you can. So, yeah. Let me know if you'd like to see more of these Reddit videos in the future. And I'll see you guys in the next one.
Bye-bye.